This video is the first of several videos explaining how to solve multi-step linear equations in one variable. Remember, the main goal in solving any linear equation is to isolate the variable on one side of the equal sign. And here are the steps we'll follow in order to solve multi-step equations. Since our equation doesn't contain any fractions or decimals, our first step will be to clear the parentheses by distributing the 2. So we'll have 2 times 8x plus 2 times 16. Well, 2 times 8x would be 16x, and 2 times 16 is 32, so we have plus 32 equals 64. Notice how we only have one variable term, and it's on the left side of the equation, so we want to isolate the x on the left side. To do this, we have to undo this addition, and since 16x means 16 times x, we also have to undo this multiplication. But looking at our steps, we always want to undo the addition or subtraction first. So to undo plus 32, we'll perform the opposite operation to both sides of the equation. Well, the opposite of plus 32 would be minus 32. So we'll subtract 32 on both sides of the equation. Notice that plus 32 minus 32 would be 0. So we're left with 16x. Bring down the equal sign. And 64 minus 32 is equal to 32. So now we have 16x equals 32. And again, since these are connected by multiplication, we'll have to perform the opposite operation to both sides, which means we'll have to divide both sides by 16. Notice on the left side we have 16 divided by 16. That would simplify to 1, and 1 times x is just x. So we have x equals, and 32 divided by 16 is equal to 2. So x equals 2 is our solution, which means if we replace x with 2 in the original equation, it should make the equation true or satisfy the equation. And let's go ahead and check that. We want to verify that 2 times the quantity of 8x plus 16 when x is 2 is equal to 64. So in parentheses we'll have 8 times 2 plus 16 equals 64. We'll simplify inside the parentheses first. Well, 8 times 2 is 16, and 16 plus 16 is 32. And 2 times 32 is 64, which does equal 64, which verifies our solution is correct. We will be looking at several more examples of solving multi-step linear equations. I hope you found this helpful.